The Jumbo Glacier Resort was first proposed in 1991 as North America's first luxury year-round ski resort in the Purcell Mountains near Invermere, BC. The Jumbo Creek Valley was chosen for its climate, access, and elevation by Vancouver architect Oberto Oberti. The environmental assessment process has been 22 years in the making and recently received an EA approval certificate in March 2012. Much of the debate surrounding the Jumbo Glacier proposal has been focused on weighing the potential economic benefits versus the negative environmental costs. This video solely examines the economic feasibility of the project.
Major proponents for the project include Oberti, the BC Liberals, the Shuswap Indian Band, and regional business owners, among others. All of these groups value the project for its potential job creation and tourism investment. The government estimates the completed project will generate approximately $12 million annually in taxes. By year 5, its annual economic impact will have reached $32 million. Upon completion, the project will have created roughly 750 new full-time jobs. Construction of the resort will require 3,750 person-years of labor.
Well, let me say this about Jumbo. It was sitting around, kicking around government for 20, 25 years. Nobody had the temerity, the spine to make a decision about it one way or another. I did. And I made the decision that we made the decision as a government that we made to go ahead with it, because I am in favor of economic development. I am in favor of the creation of jobs. I am in favor of more tourism in our province. That's what we approved Jumbo.
Major opponents include six regional bands of the Tanaha First Nations, the majority of the population of Invermere and their mayor, various environmental and local interest groups, and the current BC NDP. Additionally, over 90% of the total written public comments were opposed to the project. A detailed economic report prepared for the Tanaha First Nations by Marvin Schaefer and Associates found that the project was not economically feasible. Schaefer asserts that local spending on Jumbo will not be a net increase as the proponent had stated, but only redirect local tourism spending from adjacent resorts. In 1999, the proponent predicted a 19% growth rate from years 1 through 5, followed by an 11% rate from years 5 through 20. This assertion is questionable, as Lyft ridership peaked in 2001 and 2002, and has not recovered in the decades since. The rate of international overnight visits to British Columbia has also been in a steady decline since the mid-2000s. Additionally, the majority of jobs created by the resort will be low-wage and occupied by transient youth populations and not locals. The town of Invermere is also weary of the Jumbo project, as their tax dollars may be spent and potentially wasted on the resort if it does not provide substantial economic benefits to the town. They fear that the resort may be a disguise for private gains from real estate development.
Both the supporters and opponents of the project were unsatisfied by the environmental assessment and approval process. The length of the process was an issue for supporters, who felt that the Jumbo Glacier Resort faced bureaucratic and political procedural devices used to stop the development, such as unnecessary rounds of public consultation. On the other hand, opponents felt their perspectives were routinely ignored despite clear and widespread objections, and that the process was highly rigid, formalized, and top-down in nature. Both groups were unsatisfied, as they each perceived a government bias leaning toward the other. In conclusion, we found that the Jumbo Glacier Resort project was a perfect case study into an environmental assessment process that is considered biased towards development.
In many cases, EAs weigh the economic benefits of a project against its environmental costs, routinely approving development.
This case exemplified this bias, as it was approved despite several economic reports conducted independently and by the EAO that determined it was not feasible.